This here Lexus. Customer states, I went into CVS, got my drugs from my dealer, and then it wouldn't start. They came out and helped me get it started, but now all the lights are on and it won't go over 10 miles an hour. Why it wouldn't start, I don't know yet. I'm gonna have to look at the battery and the charging system, but it's definitely in some kind of limp mode. These are real bad. There's a 10 amp fuse. I forget if it's called the VSA or something like that. And that 10 amp fuse blows when you jump start them sometimes. Then it puts it in limp mode. So I'm gonna look at the battery, look in the fuse box, and we're gonna see what we can find. Oh, by the way, thanks for being here. Glad you're back. If it's your first time here, we're making it work. And I'm Jimmy behind the camera. You can't see me because I'm just showing you a Lexus emblem. This car is actually in really good shape. Let's get to it. Let me get this hood open here. Ah, that makes me sad. Dang, hood shocks. Gotta get the tool. Put that on there. Carry this thing with me every chance I get. That's a shame. This car is actually pretty clean. This is a fairly new vehicle, I think. I mean, it looks beautiful. It's very, very well kept. 2011. Wow, I didn't think it was that old. 2011 with 86,000 miles. Car's in nice shape. Looks like that battery's at 11.8. That's not good. Discharged battery. Now I gotta find out why, and I gotta check that 10 amp fuse still and see what's going on with that. Alright, let's make sure it's charging. There's something going on there. Doing its best, the battery is pretty discharged though, but these I want to say it's this, I think it's ETCS or something like that from memory. Looks like this guy here is upset about something and not coming to the party. That is the first 10 amp fuse after the 215's ETCS. So, get us a 10 amp. Oh, that's a specialty fuse. That's one of them oddballs. I think I got one of these in my, yep. That's the little guy. That's the new special fuse, because they said this fuse is just not gonna get it done. So we need to come up with this fuse. Because this fuse is way better than that fuse, and plus you already have a lot of fuses, so now we can make you buy more. So that works out pretty cool. We're gonna pop this in here. We're gonna grab the scanner and clear the codes. See if it changes the way it's charging or anything like that, just in case. That's with the lights and everything. They got all the accessories on. Everything's really happy. You gotta mate these two here. Male and a female get together. Right in front of your eyes, uncensored. That's terrible. It's a family show. Quit that. All right. Get Mr. Launch Torque booted up. And once we get these two here communicating, we'll come back and we'll clear all these codes and see how that goes. 16 pin North America. Now, one thing I noticed, I didn't put the headlights on, so the battery is only 1 year old. So I know why the battery went dead. They put that, left the headlights on and went in the store. You see this here? It's kind of like the automatic air conditioning. Oops, they do have the automatic air conditioning on, but they didn't have the automatic lights on. That's strange. I'm gonna turn them off while the battery charges. Cancel. Okay. Now. Alright. That took a little dancing. And I didn't want to make you guys watch all the screeching and hollering. Once the car calmed down, I got to, I put it in. I couldn't get it to go in because it was a Canadian vehicle. I didn't even think of that. So then I finally just put it in as a Tacoma. So it cares more about whether it's from Canada or the US than it does about whether it's actually a Lexus or Toyota, a Tacoma, or an RX330. It's interesting. Apparently that code that was blown, this code P2118, when they jump started it, this code is what sets when that fuse blows. So, it also has an oil maintenance required light on there, but it looks like we changed the oil. And it's not due for another 1500 miles. So I'll have to reset that. Clear these codes out. Clear DTCs, yes. Oop, there go all my lights. Boom, that was quick. Normal. I got this Tacoma all fixed up. That was quick and easy. I am going to reset the oil light. And I'm going to make sure that battery is fully charged and put her headlights on automatic instead of on. And then off we go. This is going to be fixed. That was quick and easy. If you guys ever get one of these Lexuses, you get these Lexuses and people jump start them and then it doesn't, the car won't go anymore, then that fuse is almost always blown up. It gives us job security. I don't even know that you have to hook jumper cables up backwards or anything crazy like that. I think sometimes just the surge from the battery going dead and then the surge of the voltage rushing in, you know, with the way they hook up the cables, even if they're hooked up correctly, I've seen them blown. Well, either that or no one's ever admitted that they touched them incorrectly momentarily. But I don't know why it would blow that one 10 amp fuse if you hooked them backwards, but maybe it protects the PCM, I'm not sure. Anyway, it's fixed. Thanks for watching this video. Short, quick, and easy, the way we like it. There's good stuff on TV. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you torque that like button down on the bottom. I'll see you guys in the next video. You're awesome.